Kong Racing!
Hey Internet, I'm Colorful Arty, and welcome back to Diddy Kong Racing, the final episode. So I'm just gonna start right on in, because we've got a lot to do today. First up, we gotta go back to Future Funland to do the trophy race. And I figure, why not do it as Diddy Kong? It's his game, after all. Plus, he's well-suited for every course. So you might think, but Arty, there's only four, signposts for the trophy race. Well, yeah, that doesn't mean there are only four trophies, though. Sure enough, we are entering this, and this is the hardest part of the game. The AI are extremely good on this. We're gonna have to bring our A-game big time! In hindsight, probably should have been Timber. So you can let them hit the electricity, dodge it, get some bananas, avoid the gunshots, blah 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 blah. I probably shouldn't be dropping green power-ups down, because that's only really going to affect me. Hey, Banjo! Glad to see you're my main competition. Because you are a great character. Who has great games. Even the GBA one is underrated. No, it's nowhere near as good as the N64 ones, but Banjo-Kazooie Grunty's Revenge for the Game Boy Advance was fun. And that's also what got me into the Banjo series in the first place. That's right, it wasn't Diddy Kong Racing. I randomly saw a Game Boy Advance game called Banjo-Kazooie. I'm like, this sounds fun! Played it. I'm like, wow, this is really good! And then I played the N64 ones. I'm like, oh my gosh! These are way better! But the Game Boy Advance one is still fun. Just don't go in expecting it to be exactly like the N64 ones. It's a different style of platformer. Because, well, let's be honest, it's the Game Boy Advance, so it can't do 3D. Whoa, I'm dominating! Can't touch this. Diddy was a good choice. Diddy passes straight through the start sign. Oh, poor Tip Top. Alright, Doc Moon Cabins. Gotta get those bananas. Take that, Timber. To be honest, I don't know why I'm mad at Timber, because he's pretty nice. Move it! And I never get tired of hearing Banjo go, bye! It just sounds so ridiculous. And I think we'll be hearing that a lot more when I let's play Banjo-Kazooie in the future. And depending on, it might not even be that distant in the future. It all depends on what I feel like next. I already know what my next Let's Play is going to be. It'll be a short one, so. That's right, shorter than this. Admittedly, like, this is going to be 15 episodes. It could have been, like, 8 if I was willing to do half hour in the 45-minute episodes. But nobody really wants to watch a 45 minutes of Diddy Kong Racing in one sitting, I don't think. It's always great when games can pull off anti-gravity well, like Super Mario Galaxy. Fantastic game. Okay, I seriously hit nothing there. Come on, guys. Catch up to the monkey if you can. That's what I thought. I don't think Banjo was in second, like, any time that race. And yep, we're going out of order now. We're going to Star City next. Forget Spaceport Alpha. Realized we can show off the level 3 shield in this area. Move it, Tip-Tup! You're not part of this. Though, if you want to win second... Yeah, Banjo's in, like, 7th. But yet, if I win first, he's going to win second, even if there was no way he was ever going to win second. Just because that's how the score... Aw, oh, shoot! Diddy Kong, what was that? Diddy's like, oh, I fell off! Better do something cool! Well, never mind. We are not showing off the level 3 shield. Because we gotta get us some boosts! Wow. Not every day that that happens. Move it! I got 13 bananas! There's no way anybody should be faster than me. Except maybe TT if he also has a lot of bananas. Which I doubt very greatly. You're not pushing me off, TT. Alright, crunch. Alright. You know what? Even if Tip-Tup wins first, that's fine because Banjo is my main competition. Oh my gosh, will I be Tip-Tup? No, I won't, but I come close. Yeah, Banjo was in 6th. And yet it says he won 3rd. Actually, no, it didn't. Never mind. Spaceport Alpha. I'm still definitely favorite to win the trophy race. We were too clustered, that's why my homing missile didn't work. I almost sharp-shot him. TT, that was my boost. Oh, come on, Bumper! They don't call him Bumper for nothing. Ah. My bananas. Or my lack thereof, I should say. I'm Diddy Kong, I should be the Banana King! Banana King! Yeah. Normally I'd be like, how in the world is the first place with that far in first? But, it's TT, so that makes perfect sense. I hate Spaceport Alpha! Sometimes, just no matter how hard you try, you cannot do well on this course. If the guns are against you. Alright, yeah, TT has this race in the bag. Darn it! Stupid shield. Oh, I'm gonna kill you for that. Yes, I shot Pipsy. How am I not in 7th? 5th! I hope I still won. Yes! I still won! Whew, that's good. If I had to repeat that trophy race, that was not going to be very fun. And I've got way too much other stuff I need to show off. Do-da-da-da-da-da. Alright. Oh, hang on. Open! Gotta show it off. Really? It warps me all the way back here? Fine. If we go back to the signpost with all the trophies on it, we're in for a special surprise. It's missing! That is not what I expected. I thought there were five then, but nope, that's fine. Now we will show off some of the cheat codes. Alright, so we learned who made this. No. That was incorrect. I'm sorry, it's not who made this, it's who did this. Display credits, so we can do that now. Another one is jukebox. Let's us do a soundtrack on the music menu. Also, we learned after the first Whizpig fight. Horn cheat. Alright, then there's some other stuff, like... Rocket Fuel, all balloons are blue! And other great ones, like... Toxic Offender, all balloons are green. I'm not sure what happens if you try that, but if you try both that and the blue one together. Opposites attract, all balloons are rainbow. Bombs away, all balloons are red. And then... Body armor, all balloons are yellow. And now we're in for some other cheats, like... Bogus. Bogus bananas. Bananas reduce speed, which is kind of interesting. Let's see. Time to lose. Ultimate AI. Uh-oh. I'm not sure if these work in adventure mode. I know a couple of them do, but I'm not sure how many of them. Alright, I have no idea what this is. Dodgy Romer. Really? Okay. You can also go to the code list. Yeah, so music menu's on, horn cheats on, display credits, bananas reduce speed, all the power-ups. Okay, I'm gonna turn off ROM checksum because that's gonna be annoying. I actually had no idea about that. Oh, here's a simple code. EPC. EPC lockup display. Yeah, there are just so many cheats programmed into this game, it's awesome. Off-road, four-wheel drive. Okay, hang on, what the heck is this? E-O. L A-O-B. Lab. What is this? Is this... It's just a jumble of letters. Free balloon? Oh, for the next... Oh, interesting. Free for all! Maximum power-up. Oh yeah, that means if you get like a red power-up, it instantly takes you to the 10 missiles. It's great. Let's see. No yellow stuff will disable bananas. Oh yeah, I almost forgot about this one. Type in Arnold, everyone gets huge. It's great. Zap the zippers. Turn off zippers. Don't know why you did that, but whatever. Weenies, small characters. Oh, here's a great one. Free fruit lets you start with 10 bananas. Double vision, select the same player. Cool. Oh yeah, I totally forgot about this code. Joint venture lets you do two-player adventure. Oh, maybe I'll do that in the future. Oh yeah. All right, hang on. First, I'll do the lamer one first. We'll end with the good code. Bye-bye balloons, disables weapons, and then the best one. Well, definitely one of the best ones. Vitamin B. No limit to bananas. You're gonna get so fast with that. Alright. But anyways, as amusing as this would be, let's see. Big characters and small characters we will not have in conjunction with each other. Start with 10 bananas would be great. Horn sheet we'll have on, display credits. Sure. We are not disabling weapons. We are not disabling bananas. We are not making bananas reduce speed. We will have no limit to bananas. We'll turn off all the all balloons ones. We'll keep on maximum power-ups, though. Turn off zippers. We're not turning off zippers. We can select the same player for real. Yeah, yeah. Sounds good. Oh, hey, it's the credits. Can we skip them? It would be great if we could skip the... Oh, no, we can't skip the credits! Oh, are you kidding me? Really? I forgot to turn those off. Shoot! No, oh, no, no, no. No. Magic codes, code list. Alright, where's display credit? Oh, good. Got turned off. Whew, alright. And I can show him off! Let's go to tracks. We're all small! And we're already at the maximum power up. This is gonna be amazing. Okay, TT's not normally this fast, like, Partly it's because I started with 10 bananas. Partly it's because I have a bunch of cheat codes on. Like, the little racers make it look like they're going faster, because they still go the same speed as they would if they were huge. So we appear to be going just insanely fast. This is great! Of course, TT is insanely fast in and of itself, so there's that. And off-road does not slow me down. Alright. This time we'll get big characters. Yeah, you can't have both big and small ones at the same time. We'll not start with 10 bananas. Oh yeah, I forgot about the horn cheat. Display credits. Nope. We are not disabling weapons. We will not disable bananas. We'll try bananas reduce speed. Okay, really? That was ultimate AI? For real? Jungle Fall? Whoa, we're huge! Okay, yeah, well, Jungle Falls, when you're, in a plane, is kind of interesting, because we can go up on this top area. If we're not too big! If we're not too big! Oh my gosh, this is great. Am I too big to fit up there, I wonder? No, I'm not. Alright. We are so unbelievably massive. Move a bumper. I want to use this on someone else. They're all out of- Oh my gosh, I pulled them back so far! Max level, shield. Alright, well... Yeah, we're now seeing the ultimate AI. And also the reason I look like I'm going so slow is because I'm so huge. Sorry, Arnold. Just to prove you can do it, you can be in a hovercraft on Hot Top Volcano. And it's kind of interesting. This is proof that it is not lava, but just buttered popcorn. Butter. Yeah, but Hot Top Volcano is kind of interesting in a hovercraft. I almost wish, like, on the first race you were in a hovercraft, and on the second race you were in an airplane for the Silver Coin Challenge. That could have been interesting. Come on! Out of TT's way. Oh yeah, I kept Ultimate AI on. And max power-ups. Because why the heck not? Hey! It won't let me use the horn. I want to see the horn sheet! Move it! Oh well, you kind of get the picture. Treasure Caves is very interesting if you're in an airplane, because there are a lot more places you can go. Arg! TT! You have got to be kidding me. I am stuck on, like, 2 pixels. Watch it! Yeah, like, we can fly over the pirate ships, there are different caves we can go in, it's just cool. A lot of exploration. Yar, har, fiddle-dee-dee, being a pirate is alright with me! Let's go under the bridge, shall we? If you get hit in the airplane, you just sink like a brick. Yeah, I was sure that it, like, the key was gonna be on this course, like under the bridge or behind the waterfall or something. It's a pirate ship! I honestly did not know that on Everfrost Peak you could be in a car. Oh, because it's not water, it's ice. It's just awesome. Oh my gosh, this episode's gonna take forever to save, because I save it as an HD file. Oh man, this is great though. Why is this a plane course? And yeah, the blabbermouth cheat makes your horn be, like, your character's voice. Christmas time is here, and we're in airplanes. This is ridiculous. Ridiculously awesome! Out of the way, Christmas! TikTok's coming through! And I was sure the key was gonna be, like, in this tunnel or something. Whoa, hi there! I didn't think that was physically possible. That was pretty cool. You better get out of TT's way. Windmill planes in a car is actually a much better course than it is in an airplane. That was amazing. Especially this part, because now you have to stay on the path. Okay, that was a freaking amazing. I need to try this again. That is the greatest. Yeah, I know it's not a lot different in a hovercraft, but I love this course so much I couldn't pass up the opportunity to do it again. Plus, you can go for the fountain now. That great. Space Dust Alley in a car. Let's see how this goes. It's time to find out. This far, I'm liking it a lot better. That's the thing, like, a lot of the courses that were designed for planes are really good when you're in a car or a hovercraft. Admittedly, most of the power-ups are out of my reach, but still. Star City in an airplane is kind of cool as well. This is certainly a different course. There's a monorail that goes through here. You'd think it would give you a shortcut, but it does not. However, because you're in a plane, the city is much easier to navigate. Look at all the Jetsons houses. Yeah, that does not lead to the city, sadly. I am incorrect. You can do this course in a hovercraft. But I think it would be better to do it in a car. Yeah, if you go down here, it's a fan that takes you up. It's pretty cool. Whoa, that shield lasts for, like, 20 seconds. Granted, the odds of you getting 3 yellow balloons in a row is extremely low, but still. Alright. Well, that's gonna do it for the courses. Just one last thing I want to show off. The jukebox code. If you go to Audio Options, Sound Test here. I think this is an unused track. This is everybody's theme played at the exact same time. I thought this was TT's theme before I unlocked him. All of a sudden, the sound effects are on here. Also, super weird. Just the Whizpig Ghosts laughing is its own track. Also, the last track on the Mass Sound Test is the best one, Pirate Lagoon. This is where we're gonna end the Let's Play. Everybody, thank you so much for watching all the way through, and I hope you like and subscribe if you liked what you saw, and I hope to see you for my next Let's Play. I have a feeling you're gonna like it. Anyways, have a great day, and God bless.